I'm with Nikhil. In this lecture, we will study cycloid. In the previous lecture, we have seen the definition of a cycloid, how the point is generated. Here, we will take a sum and we will understand it in a much deeper way. So, we have taken a wheel of a diameter 60 mm rolls on a straight horizontal line. So we have to draw a locus of point P for one complete revolution when the point P is initially on the road and second it is farthest from the road. So first we will draw a wheel of diameter 60 mm. So I have taken a radius of 30 and drawn a circle. Just I'll draw a perpendicular line as Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. In this lecture we will study cycloid. In the previous lecture we have seen the definition of a cycloid, how the point is generated. Here we will take a sum and we will understand it in a much deeper way. So we have taken a wheel of a diameter 60 mm rolls on a straight horizontal line. So we have to draw a locus of point P for one complete revolution when the point P is initially on the road and second it is farthest from the road. So first we will draw a wheel of diameter 60 mm. So I have taken a radius of 30 and drawn a circle. Just I'll draw a perpendicular line as the cycloid definition. You know, in my previous lecture I have told you cycloid is nothing but a circle which rotates on a straight horizontal line. So this is the straight horizontal line and the distance of that horizontal line is the circumference of the circle, because after one complete revolution the distance which it covers is nothing but the circumference. The formula for circumference is pi into d, and that is nothing but 188 millimeters. So I'll draw a line of distance 118 millimeters. That is nothing but the circumference of the circle. I'll mark it as PP dash. Now we will draw a parallel line considering the reference line as PP dash. This is the center line of the rotating circle. I'll mark it as C. The center point remains on the same line. This will be the last stop of the circle after one complete revolution. C will be the starting point of the circle and C dash will be the last point of the circle after one complete revolution. Now next step, we will divide the circle into 12 equal parts. You can divide it into 6 and 8 equal parts also, but the more division you do, the more points you get to plot and the more accurate the curve will come. After division, I'll mark the points 1 to 12. C is the starting point and C dash is the end point of the circle after one complete revolution. As we have divided the circle into 12 equal parts, we will divide the line CC dash also into 12 equal parts. If you have divided the circle into 8 equal parts, you have to divide the CC line also into 8 equal parts. Now for division of the line, you know, you will draw a 45 degree line and join the lines, parallel lines as shown. Refer my geometric lecture 1 if you want to see this in much detail. After division, C is the center point. As you can see, as the circle is moving forward, the center point doesn't change. The center point remains at the center through the entire straight line. But you would have noticed that the point P shifts. As the circle is moving forward, the point P also changes. Now next, considering the reference line PP dash, I will mark parallel lines through 1, 2. As you can see, it is coinciding with 2, 10, 4, 8. It is coinciding. 6, 7. It should coincide, otherwise the division of your circle might be wrong. So after drawing these parallel lines, we will take a distance of C to P. Now as the circle moves forward, now your center point is at C, that is the starting point. As the circle moves forward, the center point shifts to C1. And when your center point is at C1, your P point position will change. And it will be here. I'll mark it as P1 on the first line. Now again moving forward, now your center point C is now C2, and your position of P point will also change. So keeping on C2, I'll mark on the second line, and that point will be P2. Now doing like this, keeping on C4, mark on the fourth line. Keeping on C5, mark on the 5th line. Keeping on 6th line, mark on the 6th line. Now this will be at the center. So at this particular point, the circle is totally inverted. Point P is on the top. C7 to the 7th point. C8 on the 8th line. C9 on the 9th line. C10 on the 10th line, C11 on the 11th line, and finally your P point is back to its last point on the surface of the road. Now mark these points as P1 to P12. After marking these points, you know you have to join them, and for joining the points, you use French curve. So we will use French curve and join all the points. Now this was part 1 of the sum when the point P was on the road. So point P, as you know, it was on the road. Now the second part, that is, it is farthest from the road. Now the farthest point from the road will be the top side. So this top side will be the farthest from the road. So again we will take the sum. It's the same procedure, just the point P will be at the top side, and that top side locus you have to find out. You have to draw the curve when the point P is on the top side. So the same steps as the earlier. So the farthest point P will be on the top side. In the previous we have taken the point on the bottom side, that was the closest to the road. This is on the top side, which is farthest. In exam they can give anyhow, they can give on the 90 degree side, it is there. You have to just draw the curve through point P. Here also the distance of circle will be 188 millimeter, that will be the circumference of the circle. Same steps. You will divide the circle into 12 equal parts. Mark them as 1 to 12. This is the rotation. Now we will divide the line into 12 equal parts as we have done earlier. Same steps we are following. So the center line is divided into 12 equal parts as we have divided the circle into 12 equal parts. These are the different center parts, center points, as the circle rotates on a straight horizontal line. Drawing parallel lines. Now the main step. The point P is on the top side. So take a distance of C to P. That is the radius. As the circle moves forward, P point position will change. Now your center point is at C1. At that particular point, the position of point P will be on the first line. We'll mark it as P1. Now as your center point shifts, the position of point P also shifts. This will be P2. Keeping on the center point C3, this will be P3. Like that you have to do it same as the previous sum. On C4, the fourth line, this point will be P4. And like that all the points we will mark. Just remember the position of point P, how it will move, and according to that you have to mark the points. So mark all the points as P1 to P12. Now the final step, you have to join these points using French curve. So we have drawn the cycloid, the point farthest from the road. In exam you will get the P point anywhere, you should be able to draw it. If it is on the 90 degree on this direction, the curve will be like this. So according to the position, you have to change it. Thank you all. Do subscribe to my channel. See you in the next lecture.